Welcome back to the show. Well, six protesters will be charged and another two fined after bringing Melbourne CBD to a standstill during peak hour yesterday. These activists seem to be taking over anything they want, and now they're going after our farmers too.
My team uphold the highest level of care for everyone in the industry. They are doing the best that they can do. And to have these people do what they do, they have taken photos of my team celebrating International Women's Day, put it on separate social medias and called them murderers. That is not acceptable.
No.
They are coming to our office. They are pretending to be a plumber, for goodness sake, to get access to my office while they hide in toilets. God knows how long they had been there. It is appalling, and this behaviour should not be supported. These people do not stop, and this is what our farmers have been under for decades.
Yeah.
And it is not fair. When you cannot walk down to your sheds and open those doors confidently thinking you are safe, thinking your teams are safe.
Yeah.
They are doing their jobs, and they are very proud to provide food in this country. And I just think at some point people have to stand up and protect Australian farmers because we are doing the right thing. We are going above and beyond, and these people need to be called out.
Bravo.
Let's bring in the CEO of Australian Pork, Margot Andre, in Canberra now. Margot, livestock farmers have been subjected to this kind of relentless harassment for a while now.
They have. We're talking decades. Decades that our farmers have had to battle this. Invasions on farm, their privacy being taken away from them. They film their families, their children. It's just appalling behaviour. Recording devices hidden. Like, it's ridiculous. They hidden the toilets, for goodness sake. Enough's enough.
I mean, Margot, I watched this yesterday. I don't think there's been a more powerful testimony on behalf of farmers in a long while.
So strong.
And Senate estimates yesterday. That's how busy my afternoons are.
but it's
such an important story because, I mean, what are these people doing? Farmers are contributing, and these people clearly aren't. And you are subjected to this, this form of bullying.
And we need to be really clear, we don't mind. People have a choice on what they eat, the lifestyles they live, all of those sort of things. Everyone's entitled to a voice. But this has crossed a line. This is really into that bullying and harassment. And as I said, we have a right here in Australia to feel safe, and our farmers don't feel safe. I mean, we have to get our offices and farms scanned for recording devices so that we know our children aren't being monitored. It's really gone too far.
I mean, you gave us a pretty good rundown yesterday of the scale of this. Are there anything that do you think the farmers can do to try and prevent this kind of harassment?
Yeah, so our farmers have to go above and beyond in terms of biosecurity and protecting their farms and them even looking at their own monitoring devices to protect them so they can actually tell their side of the story. We do tell everyone to remain vigilant, and most importantly, if you do see something, we do have to give a shout out to our police force because they do respond. But just be remaining vigilant, looking for things, cars that don't look quite right, people that don't look quite right, actually be a little bit suspicious. And call it out when you see it. And most importantly, do not take these people on. Actually go to the authorities and call them.
Margot, this is not just your industry. This is the issue here. And we saw yesterday in Melbourne, storming a retail sector. We see dairy farmers targeted. We see cattle, meat producers targeted pointedly. And we're seeing this now with you. This is sector-wide, and it needs to stop. But do you get any indication from anyone that it's going to stop in some way?
Yeah, and look, it was really nice yesterday in estimates to see the politicians in the room on both sides of politics actually call out this behaviour and agree that there's always need to be coming to our industries to tell our stories rather than just that one photo, that 10-word heading. We need people to actually be a bit more informed. And actually, well, as I say, we need Australians to actually back our agriculture industries. We are highly regulated. We operate under very strict rules, independent audits. We go above and beyond. So maybe if there's always two sides to a story, actually let us have our voice more often as well.
Good on you. Well, you've got one here. Nice to talk to you, Margot. Appreciate it. One